Now the topic is energy sources. There are two types of energy sources we are knowing about these sources. First is conventional sources and non-conventional sources. The conventional sources can be divided into two parts. In commercial, coal, petroleum and electricity. In non-conventional, firewood, straw, dried and dug. Non-conventional sources are known as the bioenergy, solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy and energy from the urban waste. Now, what is a conventional source of energy? This includes the coal, petroleum, natural gases and nuclear energy. Oil is the most widely used source of energy. Coal, petroleum and natural gases account of about 90% of the world's production of commercial energy, and hydroelectric and nuclear power account of about 10%. Next, what is non-conventional? The non-conventional sources of the energy are also called the renewable source of energy. Example are bioenergy, solar energy, wind energy and tidal energy. The Government of India has established a separate department under the Ministry of Energy called as the Department of Non-Conventional Sources of the Effective Exploration of the Non-Conventional Energy Sources. Today's topic based on the conventional and non-conventional energy sources difference. First, the conventional energy source. This source of energy are not abundant present in the limited quantity. Example, coal, petroleum. Next, the non-conventional energy sources are huge amount in environment. That is the tidal energy, biogas, biomass, etc. The non-conventional energy sources are development phase over the past few years, and the conventional source of energy, they have been used for the long time. The non-conventional energy sources are also called the renewable energy sources, and the conventional energy sources is known as the non-renewable energy sources. They can exhaust completely due to the overconsumption except for hydel power plant. That means hydel power plant ke alawa jo bhi conventional energy sources hai, that can be not in abundant form. Next, they cannot be exhausted completely. The conventional energy source can pollute the environment by the emitting harmful gases and also contribute to global warming. But the non-conventional energy sources are environment friendly and do not pollute the environment. Next point, the conventional energy source, they are commonly used for the industrial and commercial purpose, and the non-conventional energy sources commonly use the household purpose. The conventional energy sources, heavy expenditure is involved in using the maintaining this source of energy, and non-conventional energy sources using this source is less expensive. The conventional energy sources are excessively used in higher rate than the non-conventional sources, but for not proper arrangement of equipments, the non-conventional energy sources are not used extensively as conventional sources. The commercial or non-conventional energy sources, there are different types. That first is fossil fuel, that can be solid fuels. Under the solid fuels, we can consider coal. Coal has three types mainly used as a fuel: anthracite, bituminous, lignites. And the liquid fuels under the fossil fuel is petroleum. In gaseous fuel, is a natural gases, second is water power, and third is nuclear energy. Now we are discussing about the coal. Since the advent of industrialization, coal has been the most common source of energy. Modern steam boiler burned coal in any form, any of its form, as primary fuel. That means in industries, for the energy generation, for electricity generation, the coal is the primary fuel. Next is oil. Oil is most 40% of energy need from the world are fed by the oil. The rising price of oil has brought the considerable strain to the economy of the world more. So, in the case of the developing countries that do not possess oil reserve enough for their own consumption. Next is gas. Gas is incompletely utilized at the present, and huge quantities are burned of the oil production process because of the non-availability of the ready market. There is no ready market for the gaseous fossil fuel. It is the reason, maybe, high transportation cost of the gas to the transport gas is costier than the transporting oils. Second part of the conventional energy sources is also use the water power. The water power is developed by the allowing waterfalls under the force of gravity. It is used almost excessively in electric power generation. Potential energy of the water is converted into mechanical energy by using of prime mover known as the hydraulic turbine. Water power is quite cheap where the water is available in abundant form, more and excessive forms. In practical examples, we can see the Dehar powerhouse in where links the located on the right bank of the Satluj river is equipped with the 6th unit of 165 megawatt each, which is the largest size of the country. Now the benefits, first benefit of the water power is quite cheap. Second is operating costs are quite low. No fuel is required initially because the water is working as a fuel. Only renewable non-deflecting sources and present commercial sources do not create any power generation pollution problems. Limitations are there in water power plant. In developing the project, it will be take about 6 to 10 years time. For planning, investigation and constructions, high capital investment is needed. There are growing problem of the relocation of villages, involve the compensation of the damage, selecting and suitable resettlement area and environmental impact. Development of low cost turbine and generator. Next is nuclear power plant. According to the modern theory of atomic structure, matter consists of the minute particles known as the atom. This atom represent enormous concentration of the binding energy, controlled fission, and heavier unstable atom liberate large amount of heat energy. Such atom are uranium-235, thallium-232 and plutonium-239. It is the artificial element. This enormous rises the energy and relative small mass of the nuclear fuel make the source of the energy of great importance. Now the topic of non-conventional energy sources. The first fuel, we can use the solar power and solar energy. The solar energy received in the form of the radiation can be converted directly or indirectly into the other forms of energy. That energies can be heat, and electricity which can be utilized by the human being. The sun is expected to radiate solar energy at essentially constant rate for the few billions years. It may be regarded as an inexhaustible source of useful energy. The solar energy reaching the top of the Earth's atmosphere consists about the 8% of ultraviolet radiation, of 46% is visible light and 46% of the infrared light. There are a diagram of the solar radiation of Earth's surface. We can see the Earth's surface and different type of radiation are coming from the sun. Some radiation are reflected by the Earth's surface. Some radiation can be absorbed in atmospheric absorption by the different elements of the Earth. And the radiation can be direct radiation and diffuse or scattering radiations. Some radiations are reflected back into the space. When the sun at zenith position is directly, that means overhead position. Application of the solar energy that can be following categories. First is the passive heating application, that is low temperature, that means temperature is 150 degrees centigrade. Without any special device, the energy conversion heat to receive and use the heat, such as residential heating and water heating. Also, this heat can be used by the cooking, greenhouses, drying, biomass energy process, energy conservation, and of conventional non-renewable sources. And second is the solar thermal system, where the temperature is between 150 degrees centigrade to the 300 degree. That heat can be used for the heating, water process, heat supply, steam supply, heat for the chemical industries. Today's topic is the solar energy collector. We know the solar power is the electricity generated using the solar radiation from the sun. Firstly, solar energy को collect करने के लिए हमें collectors की ज़रूरत होती है. So, let's we know what are the solar energy collectors. The definition is, a solar thermal collector collects the heat by absorbing sunlight. A collector is a device for capturing solar radiation. That means, solar energy को collect करने के लिए ऐसे equipments हैं, ऐसे collectors हैं जो कि sun radiations को absorb करते हैं. And solar radiation is energy in form of electromagnetic radiation from the infrared and ultraviolet wavelengths. Solar collectors two types के होते हैं. First is non-concentrating type and second is a concentrating type. Non-concentrating type solar collectors are divided into two parts: liquid flat plate collector and flat plate air heating collectors. And concentrating type collector is subdivided into three parts: focus type, point focus type, and non-focusing type concentrating type solar energy collector. The solar thermal collector has the load density per unit area collected by covering large area. Solar energy as heat transfer, the heat transport fuel and thermal storage tank boiler heat exchanger. इन सारी जगहों पर हम सोलार कलेक्टर्स का यूज़ करते हैं. नाउ द कंसनट्रेटिंग टाइप कलेक्टर्स के बारे में जानते हैं. तो कंसनट्रेटिंग टाइप कलेक्टर्स कन्वर्ट द सोलार रेडिएशन फ्रॉम द लार्ज एरिया टू स्मॉल एरिया. दैट मीन्स यहाँ पे सन रेडिएशन जिस सरफेस पे पड़ते हैं वो एरिया लार्ज होता है, एंड जो एनर्जी स्टोर करने या कलेक्ट करने की जो जगह होती है वो स्मॉल होती है. वेयर द बीम रेडिएशन इज यूटिलाइज्ड ऑप्टिकल मेथड, दैट इज रिफ्लेक्शन और रिफ्रैक्शन. सोलार ट्रैकिंग रिक्वायर्ड, दैट मीन्स जिस तरफ सोलार मूव, सन मूव करता है वैसे ही ये कलेक्टर्स भी मूव करना शुरू करते हैं. diffuse radiation cannot be concentrated, high temperature attained, and flexible construction. It is a concentrating type collector, solar energy collector. It's called the parabolic dish collector. They are the surface area of the collector is large, and the concentrating part is a single point. It is a cylindrical parabolic concentrator. It is also type of the concentrating type solar energy collector. It is a central tower receiver where the large area is required for this type of collector. Now, non-concentrating type collector that absorb the radiation received on the surface, both beam and diffuse radiation, no optical concentration method. इसके टाइप्स में हमने देखा कि फ्लैट प्लेट कलेक्टर्स जो होते हैं वो नॉन कंसंट्रेटिंग टाइप कलेक्टर्स होते हैं. इस डायग्राम में हम देख सकते हैं फ्लैट प्लेट कलेक्टर्स के बारे में, जिसमें एक फ्लैट प्लेट है डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स के साथ दैट कलेक्ट द सोलार एनर्जी. इट इज़ नो नीड ऑफ द सोलार ट्रैकिंग. सिंपल एंड कॉम्पैक्ट कंस्ट्रक्शन, fixed and rigid platform, maintenance free, and temperature cannot be achieved. It is flat plate collectors.